Hi children, good morning everyone. How are you? I hope you are fine and you are at home and learning a lot of things. So this is the class 5 children, page number 196. As you can see children, so we are in the textual information for class 5 children. This is the lesson number 4, that is safety and first aid. Now we are going to read the next one. Okay, this is fact 5. The clear gel of aloe vera can heal wounds and burns, forming a protective coating on the affected area. So we have this one also, we have already seen that whenever if you are applying the aloe vera gel of that is white color in there, na, whenever you are picking the aloe vera and you are that sticky one, and if you are keeping on the wound, that is also keep after the cleaning process only. After cleaning of wound only you have to keep that. It will form a protective layer or coating on that area, and it will be helpful in healing of that wound. Okay, next one, for nose blades. Keep the patient upright in a comfortable position with her or his head held back. Okay, so you have to keep that patient, those who are nose bleeding, like this, that patient has to upright in comfortable position with head should be up. Okay, next, press the bleeding side of the nose firmly. Like you have to press that bleeding side firmly, not with the pressure. You have to press that very gently. Okay, keep an ice pack or wet cloth on the nose and the head of the patient. As you can, we have already learnt about this, how you have to prepare the ice pack and how you have to keep. Like this, you have to keep the ice pack. Okay, you know children, the ice pack is readily available there in the market also. You can keep that also. Okay children, ask the patient to breathe through her or his mouth and not to blow her or his nose. So whenever the nose bleeding happens, then ask that person to breathe with the mouth, not with the nose. Okay, and not to blow her, his or nose. Just firmly you have to just keep it on the nose and take the respiration or take the breathing through the mouth. Okay, ask the patient to breathe through her, his mouth, not to blow her or his nose. A little bit of bleeding from the nose is harmless, but if the bleeding is heavy, then send for the doctor. So if the bleeding is somewhat little bit, then it will be a no problem, but it will be heavier, then we have to consult the doctor. Okay children, see, you can see this picture. To stop bleeding from the nose, keep the patient upright in a comfortable position. So you have to keep the patient to a comfortable position. Okay children, for sprains. Now we have completed the nose blades. Now we have to do what children? For sprains. When the tissues around a joint get torn, we call it sprain. So sometimes what happens children, the tissues of the joint, around the joint, somehow what happened, we got a sudden pain in that region, and that is called as sprain. Sprains cause swelling and sometimes discoloration. See, when the tissues are torn, so what happened, the flowing of blood will be stopped to some extent. Okay, not fully stop. Okay, some extent, because the tissues are torn, right, not the muscles. So what happened, it leads to discoloration. Sometimes you will see that when the blood clots, then what happened, reddish brown color clotting will be there. Okay, and so if the tissues are born, it is leads to the discoloration, somewhat the bluish color, it turns to the blue color. Okay, and of the skin, they are very painful. Those sprains are very painful. Keep on applying ice packs or ice cubes on the injured joint till the swelling subsides. Okay, so what we have to keep the ice packs and ice cubes, so that injured point means that because of the sprains, that part is swollen up. So what happened? We have to keep the ice cubes or ice pack so that it can decrease the swelling part. Okay, children. See children, sprains, you have to keep in your mind that when the tissue around the joint are torn, that is called as sprain. Okay. Sometimes you can observe also, right? Sometimes they are very painful, children. Okay. So now next one is fractures. Obviously, you know about the fractures. Okay. For fractures, a crack or a break in a bone is called fracture. So a crack or a break in a bone is called as what, children? Fracture. Keep the patient calm and comfortable and send for the doctor. Do not panic when anything happens. Children, see, even the fracture is a very serious issue, but it will heal in 2 or 3 weeks, and we have to, what on the first aid, what we can do, that we are going to learn it in this chapter. Okay. Apply a splint to give support to the broken bone and try to avoid unnecessary movement. You have to like, this is the splint, children. Are you seeing there a wooden, it is made up of a wooden plank or anything that is made up of splint. Okay. Sometimes what happened, children, that pain is very it is very painful, you know, when the fracture has happened. Give the support to the broken bone and try to avoid unnecessary movement. If there is a movement, then it will be more painful. Any easily available articles like sheets of newspaper, a piece of cardboard or a pillow around the injured bone can act as a splint. So this splint, what it is made up of, what, children? It is made up of any articles like sheets of newspaper, piece of cardboard or a pillow around the injured bone can act as a splint. Okay. This will prevent movement and help the broken bone to heal. A sling made from a triangular piece of cloth can be used for support. So this is a splint. Sling is used for the triangular piece of cloth that is used for support. Whenever what happened, when there is a broken hand will be there. Okay. So please underline, children, this one: splint, fracture, sling, a triangular piece, as well as here also we have forgot here. So please underline sprains and underline the discoloration. Okay. I hope you have understand it. Okay, children. Next one, you can see this picture, children. What is a splint and what is a triangular sling? This is the fracture of leg. See, for the fracture of leg, what the, that wooden plank and with that wooden splint will be more lengthier. Yes, and it has it will be more. So here now, children, checkpoint. Circle the correct answers. For cuts and scratches, clean the affected area with cotton wool soaked in water, oil or an antiseptic solution. Obviously, children, that is an antiseptic solution. Please circle this, an antiseptic solution. Please underline, and you have to learn this also. Okay. Antiseptic solution. A crack or a break in a bone is called a wound, fracture or sprain. Obviously, a crack or a break in a bone is called as fracture. Please underline this. And what is the spelling for fracture, children? F-R-A-C-T-U-R-E, fracture. Okay, next one. Apply a splint, ice pack or tourniquet to give support to a broken bone. Yes, that is splint. You have to apply a splint. You can able to see now here the to support, give the support, what we need to do, that we have to do the splint. We have to give the support with the help of splint. Okay, next one. A piece of cardboard or a pillow around an injured bone can act as a what? Splint, tourniquet or sling. So here, see here. A sling is made up of triangular piece of cloth can be used for support. So obviously, this is called as splint. Next, for burns. Now we are going to learn about the burns. Okay. The one can suffer burns from hot objects, fire, steam, boiling water, crackers, electric points, and chemicals like acids. Yes, so what are the things which for our like body the burns can happen, children? That can be fire, that can be steam. What is the steam? The steam, like whenever you are doing any cooking food or boiling water, then what happens, what it comes out, that is called as steam. Okay, boiling water, right? Crackers, yes, obviously in the at the time of the Diwali, so crackers also they will do a very messy thing, right? Most of the children are got burned, most of the people they got burned, right? Yes, we have to very careful in on that time. Electric points, obviously the electricity which is goes into the wire, the electric points like electric plugs, right? And the chemicals like acid. So most of the acids are very dangerous for us. Like you can see the concentrated sulfuric acid, concentrated hydrogen sulfide, they are very, concentric acids are very harmful for us. And you have to be very careful with the help while taking anything, it's any of the hot objects. Okay, now further, so there are three types of burns are there, children. What are they? There are minor burns, please underline this, minor burns. Next one is severe burns, and next one is what, children? Chemical burn. So we will complete this today. Okay, first one, minor burns. Though minor burns are very painful, they can be treated at home. Yes, even though the minor, see children, burns of any types, they are very very painful, and they form, sometimes it forms the blisters also. We will see the blisters, regarding the blisters in this chapter. Okay, though minor burns are very painful, they can be treated at home. Okay, let running cold water flow over and the burn until the pain subsides. Pain subsides, what does it mean, children? It means that whenever it will be the lower down of pain, that is called as pain subsides. Okay, so what you have to do, these are the things, the points they have given, these are the things what we need to do at home while we have a minor burns. Let running cold water flow on the burn until the pain subsides. So you have to take your hand or leg near to the running tap water, and it should be continuously flowing so that it can soothe the pain. Apply an antiseptic lotion or a cream to the prevent infection. So what we need to do, we have to apply a burn oil or a baking soda paste. Yes, that way I have told you in the video, right, that you have to apply it. Antiseptic lotion which can kill the germs around the burn. Okay, if an antiseptic lotion is not available, apply a paste of baking soda and water. Yes, obviously what you need to do, you can apply a paste of baking soda and the water. It soothes the pain. Okay, children. Next one, severe burns. If the burns are very severe, sometimes the skin gets severely burnt and the blisters are formed. Yes, so in the minor burns there is no forming of blisters, but in the severe burn there is a formation of blisters. The blisters, when you can see the burning has happened in on your hand or leg, anywhere on the body, you can see a swollen part in which the some time of water will be there. Yes, that is called as blisters. Okay, never try to prick a blister. What is the pricking of blister means, children? This, see, that swelling part is there. Now you, sometimes you just prick it with a needle or something else. Okay, please don't do that, because it fans the infection, means it spreads the infection. Okay, an open blister is an open wound. It can catch infection very easily. Okay, Jen, what are the things what we need to do when we have the severe burns? Okay, gently cover the burn with a clean piece of cloth or sterile gauze to protect it from germs and dust. So what you need to do, children, you have to protect with the sterile gauze. Like you can apply the apply that with the antiseptic lotion with the cloth as well as the sterile gauze. Okay, If the victim is in the state of shock, give him a warm drink. Never try to give a liquid to an unconscious person. See, please children, don't give the liquid to the unconscious person, and if he is in panic mode, make him stay calm, and then you have to give a warm drink. Warm drink, somewhat, the drink should be somewhat like somewhat warm water, okay, like that, okay. Next, dip a sterile piece of cloth in the solution of baking soda and use it with as a wet compress. So you have to solution of baking soda, as we have seen in the minor burns, right? That you can do, and it is a wet compress, okay. And keep in your mind that blister should not burst out. Severe burns must be treated by a doctor. Obviously, severe burns must be treated by the doctor. You should not touch, okay. Chemical burns. Remove any clothing from the affected area. Use plenty of water to wash off the chemicals, okay. Cover the burn with a sterile gauze and send for the doctor. Okay, so this till here we have completed the regarding the burns. Now we will continue in the next video. Okay, children. So here, children, what happened? For the chemical burns, you have to use a sterile gauze and you have to send for the doctor. Thank you, children.